As we try and make more and more power from a factory engine, we continually come up against problems or limitations with the factory components. And this also comes down to the castings for both the block and the cylinder head. We're here with Herman from Platinum Racing Products to talk about a recent product release, which is their new cast cylinder head for the Subaru EJ series engine. So before we get into the specifics of the cylinder head, Herman, what are the limitations or problems with the EJ head that you were trying to solve?
They crack. Simple. I mean, EJ20s are known for lifting heads and hurting them, and they crack. So we wanted to start there, obviously, as a stepping stone on a smaller, cheaper, more compact head before rolling out our six-cylinder stuff.
Because this really does lead into something we've talked to you previously about on camera, which is the development of cast blocks and cylinder heads to replace the factory components in the Nissan RB26.
Absolutely. 26, 2J, 4G63. I mean, sky's the limit, but yeah.
Okay, when you're starting with a clean sheet of paper, it gives you obviously complete flexibility, port shapes, designs, the valve train itself. What have you decided to change with this cast head?
Right, so with the Subaru, we were able to move the intake ports or valve further apart. So we managed to get a 42mm valve in there. Also being able to go up to 420 CFM on the intake. Simple things like running an M14 head stud, thicker head material. We've moved the dog leg exhaust port over to fix that issue with the Subaru head. So look, just bits and pieces like that. You have complete flexibility with making it how you want to make it.
Let's dive back into some of those specifics. So the 14mm head stud, this is a reasonably common upgrade for those making big power with big boost on the Subaru platform. Now, of course, you can drill out the factory heads, but this makes it a simple bolt-on exercise.
Oh, absolutely. And I mean, Subaru, I mean, people want to go 140 newtons. The head completely buckles. So going for a thicker head with the channels that support, like the crush tubes that support a 14mm bolt, I mean, it just fixes all those problems.
That's the other element I was going to move on to. A lot of people expect that when we start getting into problems with head gasket integrity, lifting the head at high boost pressure, that just more torque on the studs. So a bigger stud with more torque will fix it, but that's not always the case. As you mentioned there, you can end up distorting the cylinder head. So that's where that thicker deck surface comes in.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, support under the exhaust ports, for example, the RB cylinder head, it's 105 foot-pound. I mean, that's all you can ever do them up to, right? But with that, they're distorting, and when you have to machine out the combustion chamber to get the boost and timing into it, because you're obviously running high compression, you need to be able to jam the timing in and get the power out of it. You've got all sorts of limitations with that combustion chamber buckling, usually in the exhaust side, because the support's not there. You've had to remove it, so you're always chasing your tail. If we can go up to, you know, huge tension because the support's there and the deck's there, well, now we're matching the limitations of the billet block or a cast block, for argument's sake, and yeah, the sky's the limit.
Okay, you mentioned moving the intake port to facilitate the ability to run that larger valve. And I'm assuming here that the actual port at the surface to the head where the inlet manifold bolts on, you've retained the factory port diameter, dimensions, and stud pattern there, so existing inlet manifolds can be used?
Yep, completely bolted head or bolt-up head. Obviously, we can further evolve these platforms to have specific manifolds made, but for the better part, everything that we roll out initially was just bolt-up.
The difference, though, that doesn't go for the exhaust side, does it? Because you've done away with, you mentioned that dog leg port. Yeah. So talk to us about what the dog leg port is for those who aren't in the Subaru world and aren't aware of it, and why that causes problems.
Yeah, so Subaru designed a dog leg port. The first port is relatively straight, but the second port, they've moved it over to get past a cross member. So now we were able to separate the ports and make that exhaust more free flowing and fix that inherent issue, and also issues with back pressure and heat. So it solves that problem.
Because I don't port heads, I haven't seen one on a flow bench, I could only assume that that dogleg port would have created a differential in flow between the two ports. Am I right there?
Yeah, man. Massive issues with, as I said, back pressure, flow, and heat. So it's just a massive issue for the Subaru that's been remedied now. Yeah.
So moving that port, it does necessitate a different exhaust manifold, but the benefits obviously outweigh that small inconvenience.
Absolutely. And look, most people make their exhaust manifolds anyway. Intake manifold's the hard one, so people are genuinely happy with the result. Yeah.
In terms of the other aspects of the heads, the valve train, valve actuation, cams, etc., I assume the smart money will be just to retain the stock geometry and actuation methods?
Yeah, absolutely. All factory bolting stuff.
This begs the question, why cast instead of billet?
Oh, you know, billet is predominantly for prototyping. And people always get upset or question me when I say that. Isn't billet the end game? Well, no. Once you get to an OEM spec type manufacturing, billet is used for prototyping. And then when you roll it out in large quantities, because it's mass production stuff, the quality's definitely there with the cast.
And I mean, this really comes down to the production techniques. When you are making a one-off or maybe a handful, then billet probably makes sense in machining those from scratch. However, when you're looking at a larger production run, billet is going to be too time consuming, and that creates a lot more expense for the finished product.
And all the thermal expansion issues that eliminate everyone from running street solutions. So you want to cater to both markets, really.
Talking about that thermal expansion coefficient, this sort of dives into a podcast episode that we'll link to if people want to find out more. The billet material has a higher thermal expansion coefficient, meaning it simply grows more as it gets hot. And I think people would assume that aluminium is aluminium, but there's different alloys that affect this. So you can use a different alloy of aluminium for the casting process than what would go into a billet head.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And I mean, aluminium, you can cast it into a block as well as making a billet block. Billet blocks obviously expand a lot, and when it comes to cylinder heads, it's really hard to get the water to move around the ports and around the back of the exhaust port, for example. So casting those patterns in with cores, it eliminates all of those issues. People also don't realize making billet heads, when you're making billet caps out of 6061, for argument's sake, is not great for retaining oil, and you also have heaps of issues with camshafts binding up in heads, and it's a never-ending issue trying to chase. So once you get past the billet prototyping, you can get it to work. Going to the casting is obviously a lot more expensive, but then once you do cast it, it becomes easier and faster, higher production, you can roll them out and you've got consistency.
Another change that I know you've made with this is to the coil mounting. So the factory coils on the Subaru EJ series obviously have limitations. I mean, anyone who's even considering a purchase of one of these aftermarket cast heads is probably going to be pushing well beyond factory power level. Otherwise, obviously, why would you? So talk to us about the options there for coils.
So you can still bolt in a standard coil, or we've included a mount for an R35 coil or one of our new IGN 1As if you can fit it. What's an IGN 35A, R35 base with an IGN 1 coil stuck into it. But yeah, it gives you the freedom to run whatever you want, basically.
Let's talk about port shape, port design. How does this work? Is it a one size fits all head and then you can have it ported to suit? Can you purchase it CNC ported? Explain how that all works.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you can start off with a basic port, which is better flowing and obviously a little bit bigger than the standard, but we can then CNC port it all the way up to 420 CFM at this point with good structural integrity around the port after it's been machined to those sorts of levels and a bit of freeway, you know, either side, so it's kind of ticking the boxes there.
So would a customer really come to you and talk about their application and then you could recommend a porting profile to suit what they're trying to do to get the best results?
Absolutely, and the bigger valve to go with it on the intake side, so it all goes hand in hand.
Can we get an indication of maybe sort of an approximate price point for this head?
Look, for the set of heads, varies obviously, $5,000-$6,000.
Okay, I mean, really, that's not a lot of money compared to what you can pour into just modifying, porting factory heads once you start adding all of the good fruit with valves, valve springs, etc. Anyway, if people do want to find out more or purchase a set of heads, where are they best to do so?
They'll be on live on our website probably by the end of the day today. We're trying to get a listing up, but all the information will be there, and obviously contact any of our tech support lines or emails and we'll walk you through it.
Perfect. Thanks for your time, Herman.
Thank you, mate. Thank you.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.